and unceded territory, the Coast Salish peoples, specifically the Squamish, Musqueam, and Tsleil-Waututh First Nations. We respect the land and honor this tradition of land acknowledgement that dates back centuries for Indigenous people. With this acknowledgement, as we come together to determine the effectiveness of this revolution, we thank those Indigenous people who still live on and care for these lands.
Thank you. You may be seated. Are the defense and prosecution ready to proceed?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, Your Honor.
Will the court clerk please read the information?
The Xinhai Revolution is being charged with being ineffective in creating a fair and functional society. As established by the GLP-9 court, an effective revolution contains six criteria. It must include a reformation of political systems aligning with the voice of the people, an increase in rights and freedoms for the people, a removal of a dictator with sweeping power, the achievement of financial stability, an improvement in standard of living, and finally, the removal of internal conflict.
The prosecution may now make an opening statement if they desire.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good evening, members of the jury. My name is Patrick Jostad, and I am to serve as a prosecutor for this case. Today we will be presenting our case against the effectiveness of the Xinhai Revolution that took place between 1911 and 1912. We have discovered that this revolution did not accomplish a lot of the criteria that is required for an effective revolution. It is our belief that the events of the Xinhai Revolution directly caused an increase of internal conflict, and a political reform that diminished the voices of the people. With the evidence that we bring to the court today, we are confident that we will convince you to return to a verdict of guilt.
Thank you. The defense may now make an opening statement if they desire.
Thank you, Your Honor. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my team and I stand before you today to prove the effectiveness of the Xinhai Revolution, which took place on October 11, 1911. In this revolution, there are four primary facts. I will present these facts to you. You will look at the evidence that is provided in this case, and you will decide whether this revolution was guilty or not guilty. The first fact is that this revolution brought freedom, equality, and jobs to the people of China. The second fact is that this revolution modernized China, making it a more self-reliant and industry-based country. The third fact is that this revolution, bringing China into the 20th century, created more economic stability and job opportunities that required little experience. Before the revolution, the Chinese working class numbered around 100,000. After the revolution, it numbered 1 million. And the fourth fact is that this revolution overthrew an autocratic monarchy, the Qing dynasty, that defied its own philosophical roots and went against what it stood for. Soon you'll see how this evidence proves that this revolution was successful.
Thank you. The prosecution may now call their first witness.
PLP9 norms in your right hand. Raise your left hand. Do you swear that all the evidence you bring today shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you. Please state your name and spell your last name for record.
My name is Zhang Gang. My last name is spelled G-A-N-G.
Thank you.
May I be seated?
Yes.
Mr. Yan, please state your name.
I live in a village called Wenzhou in the eastern province of Xinjiang.
What were your roles in this village?
I was frequently a mediator for conflicts between villagers, and I often gathered knowledge for libraries and scholars.
I assume that you have allowed us to use your diary as evidence during this trial.
Yes, that is correct.
When did you start using this diary, and for how long did you use it?
I used this diary for most of my life, especially during the revolution, and maybe 3 or 4 years afterwards. I wish that the revolutionaries would eliminate the rules established by the Xinhai.
Was the new republic created by revolutionaries able to destroy these tyrannical policies?
No. In fact, I've observed that the Republic made China's policies worse. Judicial officials have more abusive power, and the stubborn mediators and law enforcement like me, who always try to resolve disputes and arguments peacefully.
Can you further describe your struggles with
the legal system? Yes, policemen executed charges and exceeded proper degree of suspect arrest, as they would say. Many judicial officials and Republican policemen didn't even have proper trials to determine whether people were right or wrong, or who was right and wrong in disputes.
Would this mean that by initiating unfair arrests and fabricated charges, that the revolution gave less power to the people and decreased living standards for citizens?
Yes, that is the truth. Yes, as I previously stated, these laws were confusing even to me, an educated citizen. These policies were hard to understand. I can't imagine how an uneducated citizen or less educated citizens would have interpreted these.
My name is Ben Tuck, and I'll be conducting cross-examination with Ariane Clementine. What were you doing October 11th, 1911?
As a citizen, I mostly lived in my village, Wenzhou. I also often traveled to other villages during these times. I can't remember exactly what I was doing on that day, but I remember about a week or so afterwards hearing about the revolutionaries.
What events do you think led up to the revolution?
There was a lot of unrest amongst the mass population. Most people believed that the Qing dynasty was weak and in need of a new ruler to carry them through the rest of the century. I hoped that the revolution would eliminate the tyrannical policies enforced by the Qing, but the new political system was radically different. Mediators became redundant, and judicial officials exerted more control over legal proceedings and events. I was not directly involved in the revolution. I was an ordinary citizen. However, throughout this trial, I hope to represent the voice of people like me, the voices of people like me.
In your opinion, why perhaps the revolution didn't necessarily?
The revolution was necessary in changing old policies, but the new changes became radical and the people and the population's voice was lost.
Regardless of any consequences that may have occurred due to this revolution, what are your thoughts on its effects?
I feel
as objection! Your Honor, the effectiveness of a revolution depends on its results. How can we determine the execution of a revolution without first considering and examining the consequences?
Overruled. Continue, please.
As I was saying, it felt as if it was executed somewhat effectively due to the lack of mass and major casualties. However, I feel as if a lot of the revolutionaries were rioting and disturbing the social order of China.
No further questions.
The witness shall be dismissed.
Thank you.
The defense may now call their first witness.
Yet Sen, YATSEN.
Thank you. In what way is it being revolutionary?
I am a revolutionary figure who helped raise funds and recruit members for the Revolutionary Alliance. And although I was not directly involved with the revolution, I contributed to the Revolutionary Alliance in a number of ways.
For what reasons do you want to revolt or uprise?
The Qing Dynasty is weakening during the years prior to the revolution, particularly due to the fact that the final emperor, Puyi, was a minor. In the years leading up to the revolution, there was an increasing discontent growing among citizens regarding the dynasty.
What made a crucial act on October 11, 1911, despite many previous attempts to uprise?
On this date, at least one-third of the entire military force was part of our revolutionary movement. Additionally, records containing the names of important revolutionaries were unexpectedly discovered, and our people acted swiftly and fought back. The discoveries of the identities of those on our side made it necessary to fight back, and the fact that so many soldiers were on our side assisted us in the success of the revolution.
Seeing as you became the president of the Chinese Republic only after the revolution, will you agree that it was effective?
I was elected as the president by deputies from all the different provinces of China after the edict of abdication was announced by Empress Dowager. The aforementioned edict was a peaceful agreement which established the success of the revolution, which Yuan Shikai led to the possible. The Qing Empire was then replaced with the Republic of China in exchange for the financial security and safety of Puyi and his men. So yes, I would agree that it was effective.
No further questions, though.
Does the prosecution wish to conduct cross-examination?
Yes, Your Honor.
China from imperial rule to give the Chinese people what they want, democracy.
Do you still believe that the creation of the Chinese Republic was effective in solving the nation's people's
things? Yes, I do. This revolution resulted in many positive things. For example, the Chinese workforce grew, China became more independent, and the Qing Dynasty was exposed.
If you account for the corruption that Mr. Yang and other citizens witnessed, with our evidence, would it be fair to believe that the revolution only replaced the old system politically, especially with
the young Shikai's? Although the outcome of the revolution itself wasn't necessarily ideal for everyone, it had freed China from imperial rule of the Qing Dynasty for multiple centuries. The Chinese Republic had been fleeting, to my belief, had not actually replaced the dynasty itself.
When you state that the Republic had not actually replaced the dynasty itself, then how do you account for the corruption
that Yuan Shikai was very successful in some areas. He attempted to lead China in a period of tyranny, and he ultimately failed.
Are you aware of how Yuan Shikai corrupted the system and deemed himself the new emperor of China? In doing so, do you believe that Shikai destroyed the Republic of China? In the process, did this not deem the revolution ineffective, since it only replaced one tyrannical rule with another?
I put my trust in Yuan Shikai. His incompetence to rule the Republic does not reflect my impact on this country or on this revolution.
Your Honor, may I speak to the jury?
You may.
A successful republic system wouldn't have allowed Yuan Shikai to take power in the first place. This man was able to deem himself the new emperor and destroyed everything the revolution stood for in the process. This decision in allowing Shikai to rule an unstable republic forced China into a civil war and another revolution. Does this not deem the revolution ineffective run and only led to more suffering for the Chinese people. No further questions.
Witness may now be dismissed.
Thank you. Prosecution, please proceed with your closing statement.
What is the most important part of a society? A strong leadership and stable united system that represents the people. With all the evidence provided, there should be no doubt in the eyes of the court that this revolution was unsuccessful. Mr. Gang has testified that the Xinhai Revolution caused China's justice system to become corrupt and create radical political change. Can you honestly believe this is the change that the people of China wanted? To be unfairly arrested and exploited by the new government system? This revolution was ineffective in solving internal conflict and only brought suffering and bloodshed to the people. The Xinhai Revolution even led to more revolutionary conflicts, such as the Chinese Civil War and the Communist Revolution. A healthy society should seek the truth, not fabricate lies and condemn innocent citizens behind bars. Now listen carefully. If a revolution harms the people it's liberating, then how can it be successful? In short answer, it just can't. That's why this revolution was unsuccessful.
Defense, are you prepared to make your closing statement to the jury?
Yes, Your Honor. Ladies and gentlemen, you must acquit this revolution for these following reasons. First, the Xinhai Revolution benefited the Chinese people greatly. It created more job opportunities, it led to a more stable economy, and overall made China a better place to be. Since toppling the Qing Dynasty, China's flourished as a nation and grown into the world power it is today, as well as making China more equal than it was before. The prosecution may say that this revolution was ineffective, but that is a lie. The criteria for an effective revolution includes the reformation of the political system, aligning with the voice of the people. This was accomplished by the people in their takedown of the Qing Dynasty. The people made it so that six-year-olds could be put in power of their nation. They made it so that their freedom, so that they could have freedom in choosing who their leader is like we have today. Quoting Zhu Rong, how sublime is revolution, how majestic. It is inevitable if China is to be independent. It is inevitable if China is to take its place as a powerful nation on the globe. It is inevitable if China is to survive for long in the world of the 20th century. It is inevitable if China is to be a great country in the world and play its leading role. Stand up for revolution. Thank you.
It is now my turn to charge the jury. Members of the jury, please consider all evidence that has been presented. Please offer a verdict of guilty to represent the revolution as ineffective, or not guilty to represent the revolution as effective. May I now remind you of the six criteria of an effective revolution established by the PLP-9 court. A revolution is effective when the reformation of political systems align with the voice of the people, an increase of rights and freedoms for the people, a removal of a dictator's sweeping power, the achievement of financial stability, an improvement in standard of living, and the removal of internal conflict. The jury will have 2 minutes to deliberate. Please indicate your decision has been made by holding up your verdict ballot. The court clerk will be present to answer your any questions. Your 2 minutes starts now.
Not guilty.
Not guilty?
Not guilty.